engine. You're ready to drive away. 50,000 each, I'd say. Yeah. Not really.
Yeah.
Could be more than that, probably.
Yeah.
I've
got to watch where the police are.
Security guard.
Money, innit?
I'm going to put my kid through school. I can pay for Brazil's National Bank as well.
Yeah, it's for you to answer, I do, to this question. We'll start with you, Paul. So do you, Paul Watkins, in the presence of Jehovah God and these witnesses, take Rebecca Leanne Bate to be your wedded wife, to love and to cherish in accordance with the divine law as set forth in the Holy Scriptures for Christian husbands for as long as you both may live?
I do.
Now, Rebecca, please. Do you, Rebecca Leanne Bate, in the presence of Jehovah God and these witnesses, take Paul Watkins to be your wedded husband, to love and to cherish and deeply respect in accordance with the divine law as set forth in the Holy Scriptures for Christian wives for as long as you both may live?
I do.
Okay, Paul, now you repeat this after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not. Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Paul Watkins.
Why I, Paul Watkins.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Rebecca Leanne Bates.
To Rebecca Leanne Bates.
Thank you. Rebecca, if you repeat this after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Rebecca Leanne Bate.
Why I, Rebecca Leanne Bate.
May not be joined in matrimony to Paul Watkins.
May not be joined in matrimony to Paul Watkins.
Thank you very much. Okay, Paul, will you now say these words to Becky? I, Paul Watkins.
I, Paul Watkins.
Take you, Rebecca Leanne Bate.
Take you, Rebecca Leanne Bate.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
In accordance with the divine law.
In accordance with the divine law.
As set forth in the Holy Scriptures.
As set forth in the Holy Scriptures.
For Christian husbands.
For Christian husbands.
For as long as we both.
For as long as we both.
Shall live together on earth.
Shall live together on earth.
According to God's marital arrangement.
According to God's marital arrangement.
Okay, thank you, Becky, it's your turn. So if you repeat after me to Paul. I, Rebecca Leanne Bate.
I, Rebecca Leanne Bate.
Take you, Paul Watkins.
Take you, Paul Watkins.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To love and to cherish and deeply respect.
To love and to cherish and deeply respect.
In accordance with the divine law.
In accordance with the divine law.
As set forth in the Holy Scriptures for Christian wives.
As set forth in the Holy Scriptures for Christian wives.
For as long as we both.
For as long as we both.
Shall live together on earth.
Shall live together on earth.
According to God's marital arrangement.
According to God's marital arrangement.
Okay, on the rings. So, Paul, would you like to place your ring on your bride's finger, and vice versa? These rings are an outward and visible sign signifying to all the uniting of this man and woman in the bonds of matrimony. So, for as much as Paul Watkins and Rebecca Leanne Bate have covenanted before Jehovah God and these witnesses to accept each other in wedlock, I, as an ordained minister and by the authority conferred upon me by the Holy Scriptures and in the presence of a duly authorised representative of the state, pronounce that they are husband and wife together. What God has yoked together, let no man put apart. So let's now seek Jehovah's blessing, shall we? Happy pleasure now to introduce to this marriage gathering Brother and Sister Watkins. Now, Paul and Rebecca will be signing the register at the front of the hall. So you need to be a bit patient, because although the register's been beavering away, it does take a little bit of time. The couple have requested that no confetti or rice should be thrown throughout the arrangements. And also, just a point to remember that there'll be no smoking in the reception hall.
Seriously, you've been through a lot. Now let your heart rest, bless your marriage. Grow Christian love. start on the day. That's that one. Got another one here from Joe and Jamie, from Jamie White. It says, "Dear Paul and Meshley, loads of congratulations on getting married. It's great to see two lovely people being united together in marriage. You are a very special couple to all your friends. And we pray that God's blessing continues to be with you as you start a new course of life. Lots of love, Jamie and Joe." So as soon as Terry talked today, I thought I'd better read his card. He's got loads of stuff on his card, so I can't read it all. The personal note to Paul and Becky says, "To Paul and Becky, wishing you both Jehovah's blessing as you start out on married life together. Christian love, Paul X, Terry and Kate." And he's got loads of stuff, different things on that. He's got all sorts of that stuff. But I was looking at a few things. This one's caught my attention. It's called Stubbornness. He's got a husband and wife who drove for miles in silence after a terrible argument in which neither would budge. It says the husband pointed to a mule in a paddock. Relatively, was he asked? She goes, "Yes, by marriage." And the last one I'm going to read is from Billy Ron and Michelle. And this really touched me personally, this one. It really struck hard on me. So deeply meaningful and so nice. It says, "Dear Paul and Becky, congratulations, good Billy and Michelle." So that's a few of the cards. So we've got a few thank yous here. So firstly, this is Janice Seawood. She's done all the catering, she's worked very hard. And also I'd like to say thank you very much to all the servers. They've worked very hard as well. They've been running all day and all night. So thank you. We've got some flowers.
Jan, I know you're in the kitchen, so you're going to have to come out once tonight. And we're all waiting for you. Come on, Jan. This is the sister of the God of the food. And she's doing an excellent job. And I'd like to present Mr. Jones.
Again, thank you for the service. They work very hard as well. So can we have a round of applause for the service, please?
Especially thank yourselves for turning up. and hopefully we can arrange, or we can enjoy, should I say, some entertainment. So everybody enjoy yourselves. Thanks very much.
I'll introduce myself. I must say to my dads, they all looked beautiful. And I've got in early this morning, I've fallen asleep during Toy's talk. No, I'm fine. what can I say? The turnout is brilliant. I was saying in the car on the way in this morning that it's amazing that we can have one time where both me and Amy can bear. We can have all our friends and all our family, absolutely everybody that we know, turn up to my wedding. It's amazing. It's the only one time it's going to happen. And I say it gets very important. I'll carry on. I'd like to thank the bride for looking so beautiful. I was gobsmacked when I turned around this afternoon and saw her standing there. And I still have her. I stopped looking and I'll stop dribbling. As my dad says, it's an age of entertainment. We hope that everything is built up to your satisfaction. I hope it is to mine as well. And thank the mechanic for sorting that out. He's going to be tonight's compare. And I think that's about it. Once we finish the speeches, what we're going to do is clear all the tables off, starting off with the head table, working backwards. Because once we cleared the head table, we can have a few photos. Because of the weather, we wasn't able to do them outside. So we'll just have to do back in the stage. So I can't take any photos. As long as you don't get in John's way, you're alright. And that's it, let's take the tables, please. And the entertainment starts. And to all you alcohol drinkers, not that I know any of them don't. They'll probably be open at 6:30. And that's about it. Clear the tables up and enjoy yourself. Thank you very much. I don't know what to say. The stuff's amazing. Mum's had a good one, as you've seen. All I've done really is this little piece of cardboard and that little burner. And they kept going on to me, you know, you got to this, you got to that. I know. And my favourite saying, I think, this wedding, the saying for the wedding is, I'll do it next week. And yesterday I found out when last week was. But they haven't carried on, even though they haven't got a number amount of times. But they've just been working so much through the nights. It's really amazing, and I'd like to thank them. Thank them the most.
Ocean Station heading towards Gorna. At the first stop, there was only a bus driver that was walking on board. But at the first stop, they picked up Mrs. Jones and a pedagogue named Sheila. It's a helpful woman I've ever seen. At the next stop, the bus driver picked up Paul Pratt. So anyway, at stop number 3, Mrs. Jones had a long and was 7 tonnes. Tickets, please, said the criminal. Thank you.
is the real stars in their eyes, champion or champions. So first of all, if you recall, on the first show, we had a young man named Jason Russell. A fine young lad. Do you remember? Handsome, so his mother said. Some disagree. Well, we're just going to interview Jason. He's a bit sharp of all the others, so we'll ask the question.
Thank you.
15 minutes of fame, that's all you're allowed. Very good, so remember those, but don't forget you've got a vote. That's right, that's what the wife's here again. Well, as they don't know, I'm not married, so you don't care. Right, so our next contestant, if you remember from the series number two, was the young man who we all know and love as Puddles. Was Alan Wynn. So tell us, Alan, what have you been doing for the last few weeks since your fame?
Well, Matthew, I've been working on your book, London, Lady Claudio, and you get plenty of work after them.
So did anybody understand that?
We get more of the money.
Well, without further ado, Alan Wynn, if you remember, did a superb Stars in Their Eyes. And here he is performing once more tonight. Well, who are you going to be, Alan? Just remind us, who are you going to be?
Sorry, you didn't hear that.
I said, man, who are you going to be? Number two.
He's a young man who's been a little bit busy today, so it's good of him to step in and be here tonight. It's Paul Watkins. So tell us, Paul, what have you been up to since you was last on Stars in Your Eyes?
I'll find him, mate. Well, nothing really today, you know, I've just been sleeping and had a few drinks. I can't remember. Oh, yeah, that was it. I got married. That was quite good. And that's about it, really.
I can see that your future wife, you're watching for a real wonderful, enthusiastic time for you, and she ain't glad this. So what we'd like to do is just remind us, who are you going to be tonight, Paul?
Tonight, I'm going to be Mark Kennedy.
Thank you.
This dance needs a lot of problems, a lot of people.
Oh, that will prove them all.
Circle to the left, and the gent starts to go, so come on. Can you pass on?